Three, two, one.
What is shaking? That would have been funny.
Can you join us?
No, I'd rather have him not. I don't know. I'm actually on bad terms with Matt.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
We've got Matt. We've got an audience. People love the audience last time.
Yep.
And we've got an audience today.
Yeah, we've got some special guests here, a recurring one. Señor Bassin.
Hola, ¿cómo están? Espero estén bien.
What is Señor Bassin in Spanish? What is Bassin?
Señor bass fishing. It's just...
There's no word for bass fishing in Spanish?
Cazador. Cazador de lovinas.
Is How de lovinas? Oh, really? That sounds cool. You should do that instead.
Yeah, Señor Cazador de lovinas.
That's dope, dude. What's my name in Spanish?
Juan B.
Sounds about right.
Juan B. Yeah.
So we've got this guy, and then we've got this guy. This is Weston Smith. He is new to the cast. He is a up-and-coming fishing videographer, YouTuber, social media influencer, whatever
Superstar.
You want to call it. Public figure. Does it say public figure on your Instagram? You're not official unless it's
video creator. Video creator. I'm not a public figure
yet. Could you just not
What does yours
that?
Say, public figure?
I don't know. I think mine just says badass.
Oh, man.
Yeah. No, mine. Above mine,
Is that why you can't get verified? Because they know that's not true?
Dude, that's it.
Oh, boy. This is like one minute into it.
I actually don't need a little blue check mark to reassure my self-worth. Actually, mine says personal best bluegill 1.34 pounds. And I got a bunch of tags. I don't even know what I'm doing on Instagram. Are you even supposed to put tags?
Mine doesn't say anything either. Mine just says I make fishing videos. There's no, like, creative.
Yeah, that's pretty accurate. I remember when you just said I'm a world traveler. And he'd been to, like, two countries. Like Mexico, Canada, and then the United States. So three total. Before we get this one kicked off, I'm pretty stoked to announce the fact that we are still giving away the flare truck, the Tundra, the 5.7 liter Tundra, the big rig. And if you want to enter to win this, check down below, subscribe for the Shirt of the Month Club. And this month, especially, we're going to be giving away a pack of Guggen Baits with your shirt. So you get two things.
Every single month, though, when you sign up, you get a pack of Guggen Baits.
Yeah, you get it like a new, like, so you can get like a Crack and Craw, maybe some Slim Shakes. It's kind of a
it's
neat thing.
It's pretty cheap. It's $15 a month.
Free pack of baits.
Yeah, so $15 a month, you get a shirt and a pack of baits delivered to your house every single month.
Wow.
And you could win a truck.
And you can win a truck as well. So it's definitely a smoking deal.
Yeah. Sign me up. I need
Hot
another
smoking.
Hot smoking
sizzling.
Deal.
It's a sizzling deal. You're really.
And when you're driving down the highway with your new flare truck, you're going to get a lot of looks and a lot of stares, and you'll pick up a lot of chicks. You know?
A lot of ladies.
Lots of chicks. Lots of chicks wearing plaid and mullets would be flocking towards you in that truck.
I didn't know where you were going with that. You were like staring into
stopped.
My eyes. You were like staring into my eyes like
saying
weird
I thought maybe you were
going
to take it away from me. Like you were going to like elaborate on what I was trying to say, but you didn't. Anyway, I'm pretty stoked for this one because we've got, again, a new guest and then we got Senor back. But we got some things I want to talk to you guys about here. Let me go on script here.
On script.
Just pull those.
One thing we haven't been doing or we want to do more is...
What have we not been doing? We've been doing a lot.
We haven't been planning these, and now we finally got some questions, and we're going to hopefully keep this thing rolling. But these are now all on Apple Podcasts as well as Spotify, so go click below.
I didn't know that, really?
Yeah. Thanks to our boy,
really
Wes.
Official.
Yeah. Wes has been killing the game.
Thank you,
uploading
Wes.
Uploading them.
Yeah, sick.
So, yeah.
All those donuts are paying off.
The donuts are paying off. Hey, what do you guys pay Wes? Donuts. 100% donuts.
Yeah. Anyway, that's all he needs.
Yeah, the one thing. Sorry, I mean to cut you off. Yeah. What was I going to say? I was going to say something really important. Oh, the one question that I had before this podcast that I wrote down that I wanted to ask you in particular is what is it like to balance, like, because you do you have, like, a certain percentage of, like, I mean, a lot of your videos are obviously in Spanish, or 100%, right?
100%.
100% are in Spanish. Like, do you ever find it like you wish you could balance like both like English speaking and Spanish speaking, or do you find that like you're is your goal specifically to grow the Spanish speaking side of the fishing world?
Yeah. So I created my channel intentionally, you know, to cater to the Latino community.
Yeah.
I mean, because we have, you know, freaking a ton of bass fishing channels, fishing
Already.
Channels in general,
yeah,
in English, you know.
Oh.
And then I saw the huge necessity in the Spanish community. There was absolutely no one doing what I'm doing.
First, basically.
Yeah, I mean, there were some channels that they were like doing fishing videos, but not the same style that we do our videos. Kind of like blogger, you know, kind of like an everyday thing.
Yeah.
There were some channels that they would upload like maybe once every 3 months, every 4 months.
Yeah, but you were sticking like with
so,
the...
I pretty much
schedule.
Took your what you guys have created and translated to Spanish.
That's interesting.
So
yeah.
I don't see that necessity of like crossing two the English community?
Yeah, I was curious.
Because I can just come here.
Have you ever made a single? Have you ever made a single English speaking video?
Never.
100% Spanish.
Never.
Yeah. Would you ever think about starting a second channel? That's mm-hmm. any, no, just focus.
A lot of work.
We got Wes. Yeah. He's the up-and-coming new YouTuber. Yeah. You know.
Yeah. I try to speak English in mine sometimes.
Yeah, I was gonna say the reason
a lot of cuts.
The reason why like I don't understand what you're saying in your videos is because I don't speak Spanish very well.
Yeah, exactly.
I know like the intro. It's pretty easy.
And now like I get some comments. You know, now that I film with you guys. Yeah. You know? But maybe sick, subtitles though. In the future.
Yeah, that's one thing I've heard is like it's like having subtitles in your videos like can really help boost because you're basically opening up a doorway to like a completely different audience.
Yeah.
Whereas like with YouTube, like when you reach an audience, like we think of it in the sense like I'm trying to reach like maybe an audience that likes catching cooks or outdoor, but you're literally reaching a demographic that could be located in a different part of the world.
So I'm looking into that, like doing some subtitles in my videos. But as far as like opening a channel to do English videos. It's not even in my mind.
Yeah.
You know? You guys are great at doing that.
Oh,
you know?
We're decent.
So I'm sticking to my people. And there's many like Latino countries, you know, like Spanish speaking countries.
Yeah.
Yeah. Like a ton.
Yeah. Spain. Yeah. Like most of South America.
All of South America except Brazil.
Is it really only Brazil the only one?
Yeah.
Portuguese? I didn't know that.
Yeah, I mean Chile, Argentina, Paraguay, Uruguay, Colombia, Venezuela, Peru. You know, like all of those countries. You know, Spanish speaking.
The oddball.
And they have like freaking like, we're just talking with John off camera as far as like all the fishing that they have down there.
Yeah.
It's like incredible.
Dorado.
Trout fishing in Chile.
Yeah.
You go for dorados in Argentina and Uruguay.
Peacock bass.
Yeah. And then peacock bass in Colombia.
Yeah.
Not Brazil. Colombia. Colombia has huge. I was just talking with the guy in ICAS, this past ICAS, and he was showing me like.
It's iCrust.
iCrust.
Yeah.
Let me correct you on that one, yeah.
iCrust. So, and he was showing me pictures of like 20 pound pickup bass.
Which is
like,
pretty uncommon in most parts of Brazil.
Yeah, Brazil, yeah. And he's like, I caught. He said he had more than 30, over 20.
Wow. That's insane.
In Colombia.
That's crazy.
Yeah. So, like you're starting your own. YouTube channel around the whole Spanish speaking audience, but then you got someone like Wesson who is starting from ground level. How old is you're young, you're like as far as your channel goes,
right
not age wise,
approaching 2 years here in October 2019, so
yeah. Mm-hmm. And what's
you've had a channel for
fishing
2 years.
I'm sorry, like okay, so I did like moto vlogs. I had like the helmet cam on. So wife and I used to have a couple Ducatis, little Honda Groms, and mess around doing motorcycle vlogs. Then we got to a point where we ended up selling those and I stopped vlogging for a little bit. And then I started watching some fishing videos because Devin, my wife, was always taking the bass off the hook for me when we go fishing together, like
really?
With her dad and stuff, dude. Mm-hmm.
So what got you into video, or so what got you making videos is watching videos?
What got me into
videos? How long ago would you say that she was taking the fish off your hook?
Oh, 2 years ago. I knew,
you
like,
probably
I
lot.
Only fished with, like, a bobber
and
live bait.
And how many subs
do
you have now?
I just crossed 10,000. And a lot of thanks to you guys. I mean, 100% thanks to you guys. Insane. I watched y'all's videos first. That's
pretty
what,
inspiring. I mean, if you can start a channel, like, 2 years and learn how to fish. Like fishing, as long as you put the time and you can learn it and you can like
yeah,
develop
it's a very
skill.
Attainable thing.
Yeah, it's
like
not
you,
like
you can't be like, right, you know, listen, like I'm 32 years old, I'm learning to play football. Like I'm straight up going to the NFL. Like you can't.
Yeah, exactly. Fishing,
I'm not saying you can't do that, but that is not low hanging fruit.
Yeah, it's like a far stretch. Fishing, anybody can get involved. You can go to a store, pick up a rod, pick up some Guggen baits, and catch them.
Which it sounds like what you did.
Oh,
so,
dude,
like, you were just interested in? Is that what it was? Or like
not even. I literally like looked it up. I said, how to hold a bass on YouTube. I looked up how to hold a bass. Yes.
What
video
popped up?
A few like videos. I kind of like went on a little tangent, and then here comes one of Flair's videos.
I think Flair was the first
Guggen I saw. And I think it was just, you know, catching fish. It wasn't even how to hold a bass, but I just got intrigued. I saw him like whipping the bait caster and it sounded like a supercharger man with the braided line.
Yeah.
And I'm like, oh, this is kind of cool. Maybe I can like start vlogging again and make some videos around fishing.
Wow.
Had no clue about bait casters or nothing. So I just learned along the way, started getting the vlog.
But do you push how to catch tiny fish, how to hold tiny fish?
That's how to hold tiny fish. That's probably for Flair.
Yeah, for Flair. Yeah.
Ooh, that wasn't in the search, but I should have. Now I know what to look
just
for.
Just like this. No, that's, I mean, honestly, like, I guess similarly, I when I was getting into bass fish, I did watch a bunch of YouTube videos. But I think back when I started, like, YouTube was a little more like of a community-driven thing. So, like, I could DM people.
Yeah.
Like, where it's tough now, like, you watch someone's videos and it's, like, kind of hard to, like, DM through YouTube. I guess you can go on the Instagram scene and do that. But, like, I remember, like, talking to people through YouTube, commenting, and they, like, respond. I learned stuff that way. And then through watching the videos. It's not just an entertainment platform. Like, a lot of, like I've got a friend who says that every time he tries to, like, do something, like, fix the dryer or, like, the washing machine, he goes on YouTube.
Yeah.
So, like, you can literally learn something from ground up, which is so weird now, that, you know, that that you've been able to not only grow your YouTube channel or like your, I guess, career off of that platform, but you've also learned how to do something from the.
Yeah,
you learn how to do it, that's and then you apply those skills.
And then you teach other people.
And now you're teaching other
people. It's like
people.
A recycled process. That's so
strange. Yeah, or people can learn with you. Yeah. As you're
because,
doing
it. You've probably made some mistakes. I mean, I've made a lot of mistakes on fishing.
Oh,
just like
when it comes to fishing?
Yeah.
Oh, dude. Like one of Flair's videos, random ones I first saw was that he liked 30-pound braid as like an all-around braid for just lighter fishing and then also the heavier tactics. You could be good with 30-pound braid for all these things. So I think I bought some like bright-colored 30-pound braid because I wanted it to look cool for like the videos. Yeah. Literally for the first year and a half of my fishing vlogs, it was all like lime green-colored braid, whether I was using like a Texas rig or like topwater, which you might think is what you'd use braid for, all these different things. Only straight braid.
And you still caught fish, though.
Oh, dude, yeah.
So it's like, is there really, like, a wrong way to do it?
Well, that's
what's amazing.
Yeah, but the only thing, like, I think what you, like, almost what you're about to say is, like, what gets that in your head that it is a wrong thing is, like, maybe the comments.
Yeah.
Like, when you read, it's like, oh, God. Like, that's the biggest thing for me is, like, I'm so afraid to, not afraid, that's, like, that's stretching, but, like, I'm more tentative to do stuff because on YouTube and post it because I'm, like, almost worried about the reaction. Like, people will be like, all right, people are going to say something about that. Or like, they're going to say that's wrong, even though in my head, I don't think it's wrong.
Yeah.
So, like what Parker's saying is, like, green braid, well, it's necessarily not ideal, but who's it? Is like, and who's, it's objective, I suppose.
Yeah, I think so,
exactly,
too.
You know?
Which is cool.
Like, green braid
fishing is
catches
like,
giant
fish. You can't
fish.
Really listen to a lot of the people out there. Like, it's your...
Oh, it's not rocket science.
Yeah, no. It's,
you thought some of these people would work for NASA.
Yeah.
With how detailed they get with their gear and stuff like that. It's like, what do you mean? You're like, I'm using multi... I love the where like Flair I think has done a video where like he's like working a Sharpie down the braid and like he's trying to like I'm just like, oh my God, I just don't care that much. Yeah, you've done
it too. I do that too because he's like, oh, this will make it to where they don't see it as much. So I'm using
like I'm
braid
sure
there.
It works.
Yeah.
But like I don't know, but maybe it doesn't. I don't know. Hey, on today's podcast we're just gonna shit on Flair.
I saw a marker the other day on Facebook that was like $20 braid marker.
No.
Like,
already has
Are you serious?
It, like,
you pay $20.
100% just a like a
buns
ass
some
Sharpie.
Some people believe that works.
Yeah, that's a specific for.
Well, so if people don't know what we're talking about, like what I did and what I saw from Flair was that you make a slit in the Sharpie and you run that, you kind of put the line in that slit and you run
green.
Down the last few feet of your braid if maybe it's brightly colored. And so the idea is you darken the line and the fish don't see it. So that's the Sharpie technique.
I've also heard that like you've got your spectrum, like this is just science, this isn't fishing wise. this is my rebuttal to this is like you've got like your color chart here and the colors that show up the best in like darker water, dirty water, are your blacks, your purples, and your blues. And the colors that don't show up as well are like stuff that cause like in order for color to actually show as color, you need light.
Mm-hmm.
So like yellows and reds, like that's why like red line is like the whole Cajun line craze was like such a big deal. Hmm. And it might not be like a craze, it might be legit. Like reds I've heard don't show up as well.
Hmm.
To the human eye, I don't know how fish work, but there's some science.
I guess
speaking
the
of
moral
NASA,
of the story is or like wrap everything here is it doesn't really matter. Like
no,
you
doesn't.
Need to go out and you need to fish.
I've seen
just, the
I've
only
seen,
way to learn is to put, be putting time in on the water.
I've seen people tie on shaky heads with 65-pound braid, throw on a casting rod and catch 6-pound bass.
Yeah.
And then proceed to catch more fish. It's like
it's your confidence. It's your
That's just it. Like
going
it's whatever.
Trial and error.
Yeah, and that's like one thing. Now is like I've got my confidence things. Like if someone's like, oh, they're biting deep on 20-foot crankbaits, I'm like, oh, that's neat. I'm gonna not do that and go up shallow because I just don't. I'm not good at that. I don't do it.
And you still catch fish.
And I wouldn't enjoy. Yeah, and I still catch fish.
Yeah.
Maybe I don't catch like the biggest.
Yeah, you're just a really good angler though.
Well, like that's the other thing too. Is it's like I'm too good for that type of fishing. So no, I'm just kidding. I've actually been sucking straight. Soggy
it's
ass
hard.
Cheeks.
Summer fishing is hard.
Yeah.
So what? Do you have some questions? Like I feel like we did. You have like
I want to ask Wes about the whole motorcycle.
Oh. Okay.
Are you? So you were one of the ones like running from the police?
If that happened, then it was great for content. But no, I hung around the guys that were doing a lot of that. Some of the big names like Jake the Garden Snake and Subimoto.
I've
a
actually
lot of
watched
Dallas
some
locals.
Of those guys.
So. Oh yeah, it's awesome content. It's a lot of fun. Like just popping wheelies around town.
And they run from the cops?
I mean, those are the
There's
thumbnails,
videos.
Right? Those are the
how
thumbnails.
How do they get away with that?
They just get away.
They just
how do you post something like that? Not like
I wonder the same thing, right? You running from the cops is like their thumbnail.
I personally don't necessarily think maybe the police are going to pursue. Like they maybe just don't care enough to pursue it. Maybe or
Don't ask
not
me.
No, no, no.
So you weren't not a, doing that. You were not doing that.
Well, you know, no, not in my band. I was definitely like, you know, riding faster than you probably should be on the videos, no problem. But like, as far as the police went, I didn't run into any of those.
Yeah, because that market is huge too.
Like, yeah, how many did Jake?
Oh, some of these. I think Jake had a million. I might be wrong. I'm pretty sure Jake was like close to a million.
Really?
Though.
You literally just strap a GoPro and you just ride around.
You
and
strap the GoPro on your helmet. GoPro, right? It's you like have fishing the, you have videos. The mic and you put it in the cheek pads of your helmet. That way you can hear you like clean without the wind because you're going 150, right?
150. So
it's like, I mean, you could be. Yeah. Plus, you know, some of these 1,000 CCs are shoo. So you're having a little bit of fun. When we messed around on the Honda Groms, those got a lot of views. It was so funny. Everybody wanted to see you on like the small 125s going off road.
Yeah.
Just like fishing in
we
odd scenarios.
Get some of those for here.
Oh, you.
What, motorcycles?
Yeah. No, like too little, fun. Little.
Oh, yeah.
Like Honda Groms?
Yeah.
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 That would be
we
cool.
Need those. We need those. Yeah,
Matt?
We need
hey, Matt. Oh, look, he's ordering right now.
Matt.
He's on his iPad. Three Honda Groms, green. One green, one white, and then another one, maybe matte black, if that's okay.
Yeah. Grom, G-R-O-M, just bashed up, you know, used. Maybe
look up unsafe toys for grown children.
Grown children.
And that should
pop honestly up. Should pop right up.
So I think we need to, you know, change the topic here and talk about Matt. He just had a new kid.
Wow.
You know,
And
it's been, let's clap.
Congrats, dude, on the new baby girl.
Matt, our manager, he had a new
Julieta.
Baby daughter. And that is child number 8 for Matt.
He has 3 blood-related children, and then the other 5 are, well, you're looking at 2 of them right now.
Yeah.
Basically, Matt's been a father before he's known us, and he's taken us on after he's known us. He just didn't realize what he was signing up for, and now it's too late. He can't get out. Nothing contractual. He just can't get out. He just knows he's
like
in
the
it
mafia,
too deep.
Huh?
Yeah, it's like the mafia. Like, there's nothing in writing, but he's stuck.
You can't get out.
Yeah, so Matt's had a kid. Shout out to all you newborns out there.
Yeah.
Yeah, go out there and
Flair
teach
got
your
engaged.
Perfect.
Sweet,
perfect.
Good. Train them well.
Wait, what did you just say?
Flair
also
I know.
Engaged?
Flair also did get engaged from what I heard.
Post.
Yeah,
no, he posted, so we could talk about it.
Yeah.
I didn't say anything.
Oh.
Will you calm down?
Yeah, you just
I just act surprised.
Yeah.
We haven't talked about it much.
But I'm just worried. You know, I'm just like me and you.
For
are,
yourself?
Yeah, me and you. I'm worried for me and you. Like, what's next?
Don't worry about me. I'm fine. Your eyes should,
what's next?
You should be worried about yourself.
Beric is next.
The next one. Oh, that's for the next podcast. So stay tuned.
Oh,
I like that topic.
Oh, wow.
True.
I feel like that is
okay, so one thing we didn't even say is this guy also, you basically have 2 gigs. You have maybe more than 2 gigs.
8 gigs.
We're always messing around. Yeah, I've got like 256 gigs on my iPhone, but like as far as like work.
Yeah, work gigs. Yeah.
Yeah.
You've got, what are you doing?
My dog. Oh, there's Lucky.
There's Wiener Lucky. Dog.
Yeah, get up here.
Hi, Wiener.
Hey. ¿Cómo está, señorita?
Well, continue.
You do YouTube videos during the day and then at night.
YouTube as well.
YouTube, you also valet cars.
Valet
that's
Wednesday.
Actually one of the reasons why I reached out to you is because I you were tagging us in like Guggenbait stuff. You're
right.
Fishing with our baits, which is sick, and then you tagged a bunch of stuff and you're posting cool catches. Then I noticed that you were posting a bunch of like sick cars. Like you had like a shot of like an LFA, like you had, I don't know, like a 599. Like you had crazy cars you're posting. And half of me was like, all right, I thought you worked for a dealership.
Okay.
Like an exotic dealership in Dallas. Because Dallas has a ton of money.
Yeah. Look at my Instagram.
And I was like, oh my God, like this guy's like, I swear. And then you post like GTRs and just insane stuff. And I think I DM'd you and I was like, kind of was like, talk about the baits, like, thanks. And I was like, but like, what about the cars? Like,
right.
And then you explained that you valet for like a really nice restaurant and some insane cars rolling there. So I continue. The reason why I watch your Instagram stories is for the cars. Yesterday you put, or a few days ago you posted, what was the first one? It was a McLaren and a GT3 Porsche.
A McLaren. It was like a GT3. We've been getting those like GT2 RSs, man. Whatever's hot and new.
It's like those are more common. Those are more common than like a Yaris or like a like a Prius.
I don't remember the last time I parked a Yaris, but like if it's like a 512 Berlinetta, that was like last weekend.
Yeah, that was the other car. So like in what was it? One night you had 4 supercars.
Like you guys are speaking a different language right now.
Yes,
like, no, I don't
it's
know
just
any
Porsche,
of
Ferrari, Lamborghini type of thing. It's just not,
Then of course you've got your LFA.
What about RVs?
RVs.
He wants to
if you want to talk about RVs, look, this is your man, right?
Pay, look, they take up like 10 spaces, so we just charge them for 10. No.
that'd be a decent bill.
But what's funny is, yes, I DM'd all the Googans for the longest time trying to get in front of the guys that kind of inspired me to start the channel and everything. And through Instagram, it was a car post that got John's attention that finally got a response.
I admittedly don't know that much about cars, but like I'm definitely
you know a lot.
I'm definitely into it. Well, like the thing is, like, it's just like fishing. There's a big spectrum. It's like
we were talking about this last night.
What? Yeah. Oh yeah. Just I feel like I personally feel like the car industry is just like so. It's so hostile. Like, don't say a single thing wrong when you're talking about cars. I messed up in one of my videos. I filmed a video where I rented a 911 and I accidentally said it was a V6 instead of an inline.
Oops.
And yeah, don't say that. And people were just like destroying me. And it's like, but it's like not like I was like, oh god, I was like not worried, but I was like, oh. Like it's just, you have to be so careful when you're talking about like cars, more careful than fishing. Like, I would hate to say that opposed to talk about like using green braid opposed to like, you know, natural braid for topwater.
Yeah.
It's a little more serious. People take cars very seriously. It's a big industry. Yeah. You know, people drive cars all the time.
Someone's got an alert.
Wow.
It's like,
it's all right.
Behind the scenes.
That's all right. Anyway, cars. So what do you drive?
Well, Devin and I got a few at the moment. We got like a 2010 Synergy Green Camaro, and then we got like the 2015 STI, a couple modifications.
Which is loud AF.
Loud and proud. Yeah. And then we got the Tundra, the little lifted Tundra.
Which is nice. You've got the
squeaky BDS suspension.
I tried to drive that Subaru.
Oh, we had a blast. Yeah, y'all didn't catch that video.
I got up to second gear, and that was it.
I saw that video. I went like, that guy is so ballsy letting John V.
That was the first time I fished with you, right?
Was it? Wasn't it?
Yes. You want to drive my car? And I'm like, actually, yeah, I've never gotten a chance to drive a manual.
Yeah, you said that on the video. I'm like, I never drive a manual before. Yeah. I was like, don't do it.
I was like, there's the opportunity right there.
Which is pretty cool. Then, speaking of car purchases, Perrick, you just bought a car, right? Online. I want to hear about this experience. This is so interesting to me because this is the new age of buying cars.
I'm still confused about the whole process.
I don't know a thing. Okay. Yeah, please tell.
I don't want to. I want to leave it to be a surprise.
That's what's funny. No, just talk about
it. I might not even get it because I could still.
You have to get it now because I put you on the spot. You have to buy it.
Yeah.
Just talk about it.
So one night I was a little.
Sober.
I was having a good time.
Yeah.
And I came home and it was like 2:30 a.m. as a Friday night. And I was like. Let me go on this website called Tesla Motor Works.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
And I just was, like, playing around and just – I built a car. And it literally goes, like, $2,500 down deposit.
Yeah.
Refundable. So I just put the deposit down, and I got an email saying you ordered a Tesla. And
what car? Like, which one?
I got the Model 3. I didn't go, you know,
balls to the wall.
I didn't just get the Model 3. But I still don't know if I'm, like, going to go through with the whole thing because I can't.
Oh, I think you should. If this video gets, like, 1,000 likes?
You gotta go 1,000 likes.
Yeah, 1,000 likes. Drop it right now, guys.
10,000 likes and I will buy it.
He'll buy it regardless. Just give us 10,000 likes.
But no, I did. I sold the RV.
Right.
So
I'm not
buying another car. Yeah. Like, I got rid of the RV. And I don't know. I kind of wanted to just get. I've never had, like, a really nice car before. I guess.
What made you want to go electric, though? Just
electric.
Curious.
Oh, yeah. There's just. I don't know. I wanted to change it up. Like, there's so many different things going on in the electric car industry right now. Like,
is this an investment or is this just
I might do a little Uber in. I might do a little.
You lost me there.
You sign up for Uber and Lyft. You got to maximize the
income
potential.
Uber and Lyft. Yeah. No, I want to make some video. I mean, imagine me driving people
Alex,
around.
I can't. No.
Like, that would be hilarious.
Well, first of all, if I saw you as my Uber driver, like, I just cancel the ride.
I'd be like,
real quick.
Yeah.
Not with you, buddy.
I'd be like, just cancel it.
Supposedly, by the end of the year, you're going to be able to rent out your car without even being in it.
See, do you believe that? I don't.
Rent out.
Well, because of the autonomous driving.
Supposedly, it's going to be able to leave your garage, go pick up Uber customers.
No, we're not even that close.
Run the battery down and come back, and then you plug it in.
Well, the thing, I don't know. I'm not saying.
Supposedly. That's what.
Because right now, some of them are parking themselves, and then you can get them to pull out of the parking space for you. But then also, like, the Tesla's already going on the highways. I mean, it makes sense.
I watched a video today of a Tesla going off the highway, like, starting in a position, going off the highway, going off the ramp, coming to a stop, and then going back on the highway the opposite direction.
Well,
like,
the
not even touching the wheel and going down, like,
the,
huge
the one. The one thing I don't – I'm not outing you on this. I haven't heard of it. The one thing that I have heard, and maybe this has changed because my information is old, but, like, the one thing I've heard is, like, in order for that autonomous driving to work, you have to have, like, at least semi-decent marked roads – And like, if someone you're picking up is legitimately like, I'm thinking about like where my parents live. It's like, there, it's bumpy. There's no lines in the road. It's like hardly anything. Yeah. I can't imagine a car going up to my parents' house up that hill. Not because it's like it's like so confusing. I'm just thinking there's so many variables with that. Like, how can the computer even compute
and then
all that?
Happens, well, but what happens when there's
completely
an
with
you're well, thinking about it? But so are those companies, and it's almost like autonomous driving is a thing they're working on. So I'm sure it's
I don't know what's gonna happen. I heard like that's just like a couple videos on it, and then Dice was talking about it.
What if your car just doesn't come back though? That's the
and
other
what,
thing too. Is
and
how,
then, like,
how
are
do
you
keep,
liable? Like, what
how
happens?
How do you keep that person, the passenger, from just literally not like taking your car?
Yeah, we're still working out the kinks.
Like,
yeah.
Like, think about that. Like, there's no
but
foolproof
like, there's
way.
Just been, like, there's just been crazier things done in the world. So it's just like, I feel like.
I don't know. Autonomous driving.
Think about where we were 10 years ago to now. Even, like, it's just like.
Yeah. That, you're right.
There's a lot
that.
Crazier stuff going on.
I would love to see a world where that happens, but I personally don't. I don't even know how they would even go. But, and I've also, in the contrary, I've seen the whole AI driving and you know, like. Autopilot like just go absolutely haywire.
Yeah, there's that too. It's
like
scary.
A lot of the Model 3s had like recalls and stuff.
Yeah,
so so technical. Yeah, they had recalls and stuff.
So I don't know much about cars, but yeah, I did. This was like 4 days ago now, so I've gotten like four texts. Like they text you, it's so crazy. I've never driven
Flying
the car.
Online is weird.
Never driven the car. I don't know anything about it. I put a down deposit down. I have a text going on my phone saying it's gonna be delivered directly to here.
With a big bow on top.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And it says it could
pink.
Be like if
pink.
I figure
pink bow.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
Pink paint job
pink,
actually.
Pink. Yeah. Straight pink. No, I got black with black and then white interior. Black and white interior and then black on the outside.
Ooh, clean.
Black,
wow. Clean.
Black rims. But it says it's gonna be ready August 8th. So it's literally less than 2 weeks.
Yeah.
Like you can press a button and get a car within less than 2 weeks delivered to your door. It's pretty crazy. Like
that's
the whole
quick.
The yeah. whole situation is the whole like it's just a cool process. And that's all I know. I don't know if I'm actually going to get this. It has to get
10,000. But at least you went through the process of knowing how to.
Exactly. I just did it just to do it, and it's fully refundable, so you guys can go on there and just build cars and get your money back if you
want.
They
have to get 100
likes. And
you 100
likes. 100 likes, and I'll buy the car. But no.
Yeah.
52.
That's pretty much all I know about cars. And
Wow.
Yeah. Cars are cool. Cars and fishing go hand in hand.
Yeah.
Although, a lot of people
But like
disagree.
You were saying, like, if you were to, say, get a sports car, John, like, and you wanted to use it in your videos, like, you wouldn't want to put it in your videos because you'd get backlash.
Well, yeah. Well, because it's like sometimes it's the type of like it's like the one thing that the comments I saw is I never really, when I had my Porsche.
Yeah.
And you would post videos where it would just be in the background. People would say like, and again, I don't care, but a part of me also
but
like
no,
I don't necessarily want to see
it. Yeah. So it does click in your mind.
It clicks, but
yeah.
It's not like I'm not gonna freak out. In other words,
yeah.
There's there's extremities and stuff like that. So when I saw like people commenting about it, like, oh, like of course you wouldn't buy like a manual. Like in order, the perfect car for a YouTuber or anyone to buy, or like a car that
Pan Amera comes in manual.
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh that's just it. Like it doesn't come in America. Like when you want a certain car, like you want that car for whatever reason but some people don't understand the fact that you want that car for whatever reason. They don't like almost let you enjoy something.
Yep.
Some people, not everyone, some people would be like, oh, that's a sick car. Really like that. But other people would just be like, oh, you should have gotten a fully manual C7 Corvette Z06, and it's like, well, I don't want that car. That's
right.
A great car, but I don't like, you know. So it's just
you just can't make everybody
happy.
Well, but you
but
also
think,
don't want to like I don't know.
But I think the large chunk of the car community, like, doesn't ever get happy.
Yeah.
That's my
yeah.
point. It's like okay, so you see the 10% that doesn't get happy, but I think it's like a 50%. It's like a 50-50 ratio of like
yeah.
people that are like on board and then completely off board and then just want to shit on you. I follow Motor Trend, which is like a big publication for automobiles and stuff like that, and they cover like the newest
like
releases.
Is this on Instagram or is it just
Instagram?
Like,
yeah.
Instagram,
so like
okay.
the new Corvette came out, the C8. It's a mid-engine car. It looks like a Ferrari. Whatever. It's got people up in arms. Like some people really hate it. Some people really like it. It's like almost contingent to the super release and stuff like that. And you go in the comments of like Motor Trend being positive, hyping this car up, saying how it's such a unique car for 2020, and then it's just like on the car.
Oh my
like
gosh!
Continuously,
yeah.
And it's like people who in the car will never even be able to buy the car in the first place. They're like, oh my god, I can't believe they didn't make a manual of this car. We're like, why does it even matter? There's no way you're gonna buy this. Like
yeah.
you don't. You probably won't buy. Not.
I feel like that's just the internet in a nutshell.
It's just
nutshell,
so
though.
Weird.
It's just like.
Everybody has
but
their
dude,
opinion.
But
have you, like,
if you go on, but I'm, what I'm saying is specifically, if you go on these car, like I've
oh,
noticed
it's bad.
It,
yeah, yeah,
it's
bad.
Like really
yeah, yeah.
bad. Whereas like if you go on like a product release of like, I don't know, like the, like a new Lure or something like that, there's definitely less negativity.
Yeah.
There's negativity everywhere, but
I don't like
think,
the trunk space on that crankbait.
On the trunk space. Yeah, that's not four-wheel drive. Yeah. I mean, I think there's like more things to complain about with cars. I get that it's a different industry. There's more eyes, so therefore you're gonna get more opinions. But anyway, there's my fat ass rant for the day. I hope you guys enjoyed that one. But yeah, this was fun.
This was a good video. This was awesome.
I like talking cars. I like talking about, you know, fishing.
Your mistakes.
You know, lots of everyone makes mistakes.
Engagements. Yeah.
Some people.
No, I'm not getting.
Some people. You know.
No.
Some people get engaged. Some people buy Porsches.
Some people buy
just Teslas.
Teslas.
Online.
Life decisions.
Well, they're a little happy.
A little happy. What does that mean? Cut. No, this was fun. Thank you guys so much for coming.
Hopefully you guys enjoyed.
Our pleasure. Thanks for having us.
Check out these guys below. We will leave their YouTube channels below. Go subscribe. Go check them out. They've got awesome fishing content and some crazy car videos and some awesome stuff. So check it out. Thanks again for tuning in to another Guggen Squad Guggencast. And
let's take out the Subaru.
Gracias.
Do it.
Nos vemos. See you next time.